So I did a whole series of paintings called Beauty and the Burn. So I spent probably a year and a half working on this process and had a big show. Part of the proceeds donated to the community fund. And in the journey, I've learned so much. And I guess the one thing I want to say is that creativity and ideas can come from directions you never think about. The idea behind this is spot fires. And spot fires are these little fires that leap ahead of the main burn area. And they are happening because of the intensity of the fire, and a lot of the pine cones or spruce cones are just projectile out to maybe as much as a mile ahead of where the main burn is, and it lands and it starts a little spot fire. So I've done a series of spot fire paintings here, and that's what the idea behind this is. So let's get started, and I'm going to just treat this just like it is a white paper. A lot of this is just going to bead up and drip through, but that's okay. I'm wetting this on aquaboard and then just diving into the subject. And let's dive in. I'm going to take some of the phthalo blue green shade with a little of the pyrrole red, and we'll just pop that in. I'm going to get a little stronger dark into this foreground. With it, I want to leave that strong gold back there. And then I want to pick up a little stronger dark along the upper edge of this gold lip. I can come in and I can take these cotton swabs and lift into this and create some interesting marks that could be like logs in the foreground or whatever. So it just adds to the paint, visual qualities of the paint. I'm going to come in with some Q-tips and start to paint these burnt trunks and draw down. This is with the a lot of these burned trunks have this look about it. For some reason, they'll have little marks, that are a little thicker and thinner. So I found that again, the Q-tip or the cotton swab is a good way to make this happen.